Good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining in for this series of webinars on conveyancing skills. As this lecture has been organized by the NSS unit of GLC, we shall begin today's session by playing the NSS song, followed by a short introduction to NSS itself. So the song first.
समाज के लिए उठे उठे जगे स्वराष्ट्र के लिए जगे जगे स्वयं सजे व सुंदरा सवार दे स्वयं सजे व सुंदरा सवार दे हम उठे उठे गजब हमारे संग साथियों आसमान को उतार दे जमीन पे आसमान को उतार दे
स्वयं सजीव सुंदरा सवार दे
स्वयं सजीव सुंदरा सवार दे
Okay. And with that, we can move to the introduction of NSS itself. So the National Service Scheme is a government-sponsored public service program conducted by the Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports. Popularly known as NSS, the scheme was introduced in 1969 with the primary objective of developing the personality and character of the student youth through voluntary community service. Very appropriately, the motto of NSS is, "Not me, but you." NSS attempts to establish meaningful links between campus and community, college and village, and knowledge and action. The NSS unit of Government Law College, Mumbai, was formed 11 years ago. Our primary means of providing service this year has been through imparting educational online sessions, this webinar on conveyancing skills in collaboration with various practicing advocates is our latest effort towards that goal. And on that note, I'd like to now introduce the speaker for today. Advocate Nusrat Shah is a senior advocate in Bombay High Court, a special visiting faculty of Government Law College, a platform through which he has helped many students and clients over the years, both personally and professionally. In fact, some of the faculty at GLC have themselves been his students. A shining jewel in the field of law, he possesses outstanding knowledge of the Civil Procedural Code and Criminal Procedural Code and various other acts as well. Today, however, we will particularly be an audience to his expertise in his conveyancing skills. For today's lecture, he will also be assisted by Advocate Marcy Bhushan, and we are glad to have the both of you with us today. Before we finally begin with the lecture, we must also introduce our principal, Dr. Asmita Vaidya. She has completed her LLM, an MBA, and a PhD in law. She has worked as the principal of N.B. Thakur College of Law, Nasik, for the last 12 years, and she has recently joined us here as the principal of GLC on the 5th of March, 2021. So with that, we may begin with today's lecture. And so if you need any assistance from NSS during this lecture, please call out to Prajwala. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Should we begin our lecture today?
Yes, sir, you may begin.
Yes. Yeah, we will take up today the various skills of drafting, various types of pleadings right from the lower court, namely, for example, lower court starting with the Magistrates Court, Sessions Court, and the Honorable High Court, even Supreme Court. And especially we confined to the city of Mumbai, where we have several courts. So we have civil court like the Court of Small Causes Court, the City Civil Court, and the original site High Court Bombay, where the civil cases are dealt with. Now you want me to deal with the first civil cases or criminal cases? Please let me know. What is your preference of the students? We'll take up the various drafting skills and how it is done. And also we'll take some of the statutory notices in various provision, which is a condition precedent before filing of a suit. So may I take up first civil cases or may I take up first criminal cases? Drafting of a bail application, drafting of anticipatory bail application, drafting of petition for quashing direct petition, revision application, appeals, or drafting of a plaint in civil cases, small causes court, city civil court, high court. Any one of you can show me precedents, or Mansi can help me in that regard.
So the students in chat are asking for criminal cases to be taken.
Criminal cases. Okay, we'll take it up. The first starting point in a criminal law, well, yeah, you all of you know that the criminal law is set into motion by filing a FIR. So you must remember clearly before going to the court of law, section 154 CRPC. 154 CRPC, you all know I won't be dealing with it. Remember, you are 154 CRPC. Pursuant to 154 CRPC, where the offense is non-bailable or cognizable, the police officer has a right to arrest you under section 41 CRPC. All of you know that. The second point, arrest provision. Then immediately the accused is arrested, the police officer is required to give the grounds of his arrest and inform his right of bail, that is section 53 of the Code of Civil Procedure. Please remember that. Police officers many times don't reveal it. Then another important section is section 55 and article 22 of the Constitution of India, that the accused must be produced within 24 hours before the nearest magistrate to enable him to secure bail. Now the police officer produces him under the provisions of Section 167(2) CRPC for the purpose of securing a remand application, because a custody of an accused person beyond 24 hours is illegal. Means the law, the legislature expects under the CRPC, the investigation must be completed within 24 hours, which is highly impossible. That is why the police officer who arrests the accused person is required to bring the accused person to the learned magistrate, a judicial magistrate in the city of Mumbai, metropolitan magistrate, though you know the differences. So he is brought at this stage, the learned magistrate performs very important judicial functions. Whether I should grant the police officer further custody, that is called either remand him to judicial custody or police custody. That important provision. If he is granting custody to the police officer, he cannot grant more than 15 days time. Or the, at the same time, the accused person has a right to urge, make an application for bail. Isn't it? So it's the police versus the prosecution and the defense. So at this relevant time, the police officer who's arresting the and bring before the magistrate has to bring a police case diary. A case diary is explained to you under Section 172 CRPC, and the accused person or his advocate will not be in a position to have access to this. Only the learned magistrate can peruse what the police officer has written and any adverse comments against him, cognizable case is made out, what steps is taken out, what is he doing, or in what direction has he collected material or not. So I am now talking in terms of the rights of the accused. Now this is all non-bailable offenses. I am talking to mean, see, offenses are bailable, non-bailable, compoundable, non-compoundable. Apart here, non-bailable offenses where the accused person will be required to make an application under Section 437 CRPC. Please note that. Please note that magistrate court is a court of original jurisdiction in CRPC, that you should remember Section 190 CRPC. 190 ki CRPC ke hisab se aapko, you will come to know, it is a court of original jurisdiction. All matters, every person arrested, maybe for a session tribal case, high court tribal case, a special court tribal case, he is brought before the magistrate, the local magistrate from where he is arrested. So Section 190 is very important, which discloses that here, magistrate's court is a court of original jurisdiction, save and except. The court of sessions is only, normally the court even doesn't normally take cognizance of the matter in a virginal manner, except under Section 196, where the defamation of a 199 subclause, so defamation of the President of India, Vice President, public officer take place. Unless it is only after the committal proceeding take place by the magistrate, the matter goes to tribal, to sessions court. That is under Section. So you draft the application for bail. So application will be under the provisions of Section 437. These are the powers of the magistrate to grant bail. And please, you first ascertain, number one, whether the magistrate has jurisdiction to try this matter or not. So CRPC in the chapters 18 check, you'll come to know cases triable before a court of session, cases triable before a magistrate in a warrant cases, and cases otherwise than warrant cases, then summary trials, these are all there. Now you can make this application for bail under Section 437 if the offense is triable before the magistrate. In the court of magistrate itself, we have to make the application. Sometimes the offenses are triable by the session judge. In that event, there are some conflicting judgments of Delhi High Court and Bombay High Court and some other High Court. The magistrate has no jurisdiction to grant a bail in respect of offenses triable by the court of session. It is advisable to go to session court and apply for bail. Like Arnav Goswami's case, where the offense was committed in Alibaug, you know that here. So the application was made for bail before the magistrate in Alibaug, who rejected the application, holding that the trial is a session tribal case under Section 309 CRPC. So I do not have the jurisdiction. So the Arunagosami's lawyers, for reason best known to them, they did not move the Sessions Court. They directly moved the Bombay High Court under Article 226, bypassing the alternate remedy available. Then the High Court rejected the matter, went to SLP, and they were lucky enough to get the order under Article 136, which the Supreme Court rarely exercises powers, in rarest of rare cases, with great circumspection. So in IPC, when you see, you must have the handbook of your CRPC, a Criminal Major Act, when you are drafting the bail application, either before the Court of Sessions or before the learned magistrate. Section 437 applications will be drafted and presented to the learned magistrate. Whereas in case you want to move the Court of Session, the applicable section is section 439, both Session Court and High Court, when your application is rejected by the magistrate. Now, what exactly are the requirements? Say, for example, your client is arrested for offense under section 354, which is outraging the modesty of a female woman. Now, the offense is, though punishable for 2 years, it is a cognizable offense. I mean, a police officer can arrest you under section 41 without a warrant from the magistrate. Now, your application will go to the magistrate. Normally, you mentioned this, suppose maybe it's a Bandra, Andheri Court. So each area, there are magistrates where the population is more than a million. You all know that here. I won't come into section 7, 8, 9, 10 of the CRPC that you understood. Now, what exactly the contents of your application at this stage? As a young lawyer, as a student, the moment an accuse comes to you, the police office normally doesn't disclose to you the name of the accused. Under the provisions of section 53-54, the police officer is bound to inform the grounds of arrest to the accused or to his near relations who go in the police station door. So when that moment here, they will come to know that here he is being produced before the magistrate tomorrow. Immediately, as a young lawyer, what will you do? You draft to keep a format printed available. They're available, but you should use your own legal mind. For example, you find out whether the accused person was arrested. Was he produced before the magistrate? Number two, was he given the grounds of arrest? Number two, was any of the friends in the family are told or not? Then it is better sometimes the police don't give you the record. Police don't give you the first information report. But once that first information is filed under 154, it is mandatory for the police to transmit the FIR to the magistrate's court. So in every magistrate's court, if you go, you are staying in Bandra area or Andheri area, or maybe in Colaba. You find out from the magistrate's court, concerned court, even a chokidar will tell you, this particular police station, the matter goes to court, the customs matter go to the esplanade court. So in every court, there is a remand court. A remand court means where the accused is produced. Court ke upar aap, every police station ke aap, you will find big bunches of documents containing the FIRs and remand application. So as a young lawyer, you will find out whether the FIR ke andar your name is mentioned or not, implicated. Apply for certified copy, or you can take it down. As a lawyer, you are permitted to go to the court and take it down and jot down the FIR name and the name of the accused, police station, when was he arrested, who made the complaint. I mean, at this stage, prima facie, a limited information available to you for applying for a bail. You may not get the full, because police is yet to conduct further investigation, and he files the report under section 173 CRPC, which will take a longer time. So you go through minutely because the learned magistrates comes may about 10 o'clock, 10:30, 11 o'clock. You reach court about 9:30 and the courtroom is open, note down the, see the remand application. The police officer has taken any strong objection. What are the steps he has taken so far? What is his finding so far? And find out the lacunas in his report and make an application before the magistrate. Because you can make as a lawyer, you can send the vakalatnama, give an undertaking to the court that my client is in custody. At the moment, I am not in a position to file vakalatnama. I undertake to file. The courts are liberal. They permit you. Not to worry. And somebody is instructing you, or you may ask your client whether he was treated well or not treated well. Under the provisions of law 54, the police officer is enjoined with a duty to take the medical treatment of the accused person. You may ask the accused person, check from him whether he has made any confession. Was he compelled to make any confession to the police officer? And if he has made it, immediately retract it. Keep an application for retracting the statement ready. Suppose they cannot do that, police statement made to a police officer, confession not binding under section 24, 25, 26 of the Evidence Act, and not to worry about that. Though they are required to hold even identification parade under section 55(2) of the CRPC. Check whether your identity was there, because you can take up the plea of alibi. At the time of the commission of the offense at Colaba, I was not there. I was elsewhere. I had gone to Dubai or Calcutta. You may take, produce your case. So that is how there's reason to check all these facts and figures, then arm, make present an application. First, your prayer will be before the learned judicial magistrate so-and-so or metropolitan magistrate, court number so-and-so, Mumbai, bail application number so-and-so, in remand application or FIR number. Remand application, police station provides it. Or FIR number mil gaya aapko, FIR number daliye, so-and-so. Then write me likhi aap, in the matter of bail under section 437 CRPC. Then the name of your client, Mr. XYZ, is the accused person or applicant. Versus state of Maharashtra. Please, the state is the person which conducts the investigation under the scheme of our legal system. So the state of Maharashtra, at the instance of Colaba police station, Andheri police station, CID, whichever person who has arrested him, you have to address them as state of Maharashtra. If the Delhi police is arresting you, CBI, at the instance central government, state of Maharashtra, central government at the instance of so-and-so, CBD so-and-so. It is the government responsible to conduct the criminal prosecution. Or your first starting session, may it please your honor, you mentioned, normally some lawyers mention, may it please your worship, or may it please your honor, is the most appropriate word. Then on behalf of the accused person, it is respectfully submitted as an application, open meeting, application for bail, interim bail, under section 437 CRPC, which you are supposed to remember. Then underline karne ke baad likhi aap, at the outset, I am advised to submit that the accused has been falsely implicated in the case. Why this statement? Because in Indian legal system, every accused person is presumed to be innocent unless and until he is discharged, he is convicted by the court of law. So this is not a stage of conviction. So he is presumed to be innocent. So your first statement is that here, the accused person has been wrongly implicated. And there is no incriminating evidence against him. Or you may say that the police officer has wrongly extracted statement here, which is in violation of his fundamental right under Article 20 surplus 3 of the Constitution. You cannot be permitted to make incriminating statement against yourself. You know about this factor here. So the police officer tomorrow cannot take your statement and give publicity in newspaper. He has given confession. That is illegal. Don't go by newspaper media report. So this is all illegal. You may say, take up the plea here. I have been falsely implicated. The allegations against me are totally illegal. And there is no incriminating evidence against me at this stage. Then most important fact for bail, the accused person has firm roots in society. Yeah? Because you are not running away. The accused person will fully cooperate with the investigation agency, though he is falsely implicated. He doesn't have any role, but I am prepared to fully cooperate. And there is absolutely no purpose is being served by putting me in custody. Custodial detention is unwarranted. The custodial detention of the accused is absolutely unwarranted. By keeping him in custody, the accused person's fundamental right to life and liberty under Article 21 will be violated. His children and the family members will be in constant agony, mental torture, which cannot be monetarily compensated in terms of money. That I will suffer loss. So in the light of this fact here, I am available for investigation. I am not running away. I am a family man. I have firm roots in society. And taking into consideration the bald allegation, the FIR, and no incriminating evidence at this stage, that this honorable court be pleased to enlarge the accused on bail on such terms and condition which the accused is ready and willing to abide. Aap samjhe? This is what then advocate for the public. This is your application for bail. Anybody want to ask me any question? Please ask.
Sir, you have explained it so thoroughly that there is no doubt and no question about it. Even more than we expected, you have explained it.
I'm happy to note that you understood it.
Thank
you. Yes, this is an application you made. Yes, Ashish, boliye.
Sir, is there any room for discretion, sir?
It is totally a discretionary order. It's a judicial mind. It's a judicial order, mind of a magistrate who will exercise with great circumspection and great caution, keeping in balance the requirement of the society, crime to be abated, and also your fundamental rights. Magistrate has got a great discretion, like a civil judge, while granting injunction under Order 39, Rule 1 and 2 CPC, to grant or not to grant prohibitive orders. So the responsibility of a magistrate is much more greater. But at the same time, if the accused person or his advocate is able to satisfy before the court, he is not running away anywhere. Number one, he will fully cooperate. The gravity of the offense is absolutely unimportant. It may be a murder case. It may be attempt to murder case. It may be a serious charge of allegation, outraging the modesty. All offenses are basically very grave in nature. You know that. The magistrate should not supposed to be act vindictive. Just because it's a crime, he has put him in custody and teach him a lesson. There are some magistrate that is, there is no such room. Because there are guidelines given by the Supreme Court in the matter of bail. Jogendra Kumar scare, check karega, malum padega. When you go on the net, check karo, Jogendra Kumar scare. The guidelines given by the Supreme Court in the matter of bail. The Supreme Court, Justice Krishna Iyer says, right to bail is a matter of course. Jail is an exception. Kya bolte? In Motiram's case, aap check karenge, malum ho jayega. When you grow older in the profession and as you become, you'll come to know that here. Now, these are in non-bailable offenses where the magistrate grants it. Provided, I'm just confining this case to cases which are triable before the magistrate. Now, all of you know that here, cases triable by the magistrate under the CRPC, when you just keep a track of it, section 200 and, I'll just give you 238, chapter 19, trial of warrant case before a magistrate in cases incident and police report, that is FIR ke andar, 238 se lekar section 243 tak. This is all cases triable before a magistrate. Then there are cases from section 244 se lekar, 244 se lekar, then 244, 250 cases instituted otherwise rather than a police report. These are private complaints under section 200. So these are the private complaints where you can seek a bail application. Isn't it? Then there are summons cases under the police officer himself has the power to grant bail under the provisions of section 436. 436 is a provision. Sometimes the police officer, overzealous police officer, with a view to teach a lesson. Samjho, for example, aap driving license nahi leke gaye, aapko andar kar diya. Isn't it? You abuse your friend under 506, aapko andar kar diya, to teach a lesson. Or you are playing matka in the open road. This is a bailable offense under the Bombay Prohibition Act. He put you in jail. But a senior police officer, he has a power to grant a bail under section 436. Aap check kar lijiye, the police officer himself has a power. Because the magistrate court should not be overburdened. These are all bailable offenses. Aap bolne, when you open the CRPC in the schedule, first schedule, you come to know what are the offenses which are triable by magistrate, triable by the court of sessions, and triable by the everywhere. See the first schedule classification, check karenge aap. Offense, punishment, cognizable, bailable, non-bailable, by which court it is triable. This is what you must remember. This is a Bible for every criminal practitioner. I do not want you to just confine to criminal law when you start practicing. Please practice in civil cases, criminal cases, labor matters, and cooperative court matters. So you'll become a very pokta and very, very talented advocate. Then after some time, with the passage of time, you decide, kya karna hai aapko? And because it's not like a medical practitioner who is just doing heart specialist, eye specialist, and so-and-so specialist. No, as a young lawyer and as a senior lawyer in the Supreme Court and High Court, you should be well-versed with each and every law. See that all lawyers are practicing in all law. You should know the Evidence Act thoroughly, CPC, CRPC thoroughly, and provisions of Transfer of Property Act, Specific Relief Act, everything should come by heart to you. So don't confine to one field, I'll advise you. That is a very weakest practice, I would say that. So initially, for at least 5 days, you start practicing under law. You will begin liking it. Forget the fact that don't become selfish. I want to make money in this field. I have got precedent collected. My father was practicing in this branch of law. I will confine. No. Please read all laws, A to Z. Apart from all laws, history, geography, general knowledge, newspaper, padhte jaiye, encyclopedia, everything is there with you. So that is how it works. Now coming to section 436, the police officer, the senior officer, every police station has a DCP and ACP. They have power to grant bail in bailable offenses. The offense is bailable. Dekhi aapke section 119 ke andar, ye bailable offense hai. You can go to the magistrate. Then there are lots of sections which are bailable offenses. I do not want to mention to you. They have sections. So the time of the court is not wasted. The police officer, sensible man, dega. But many times the police officer don't give you. Then you come back before the magistrate, you will tell the court, my lord, I have been implicated in a charge, which is a bailable offense. The police officer ought to have released me and he has not done. I am therefore before your lordship to kindly grant me the bail on such terms and condition, I undertake to abide by yourself. So magistrate will give a bail on the same day. Abhi a pandemic ke andar, many people's cars are being confiscated by the magistrate. You know that, all of you knowing it. Because car apne barabar use nahi kar rahe, raat mein use kar rahe, you are violating the pandemic act and you are violating the police direction, government direction. So the police officer had to write to arrest you. Aap ghoom rahe without mask also. These are all bailable offenses. So the police officer himself can grant you bail. Otherwise, under section 436, the learned magistrate of the area can grant you bail. Now, come to...
There is a good question about this. There is a bailable offense and the police officer denied to grant bail, and he, the person or his relative approaches lawyer and he advises ki it is a bailable offense, and how do you advise that a lawyer should go to police station and emphasize on that?
Yes, I would advise as a young lawyer, they should not have any harm in going to the police officer and meeting a serious officer, senior man, and keep your mind cool. You should also know the procedure at the police station. So don't feel shy to hesitate to visit the police station. As a young lawyer in my junior days, I used to go to police station every day. In fact, the police officers are so nice and kind. If you talk to them nicely, they offer you a cup of tea and grant the bail. It has happened. Yes, it has happened. They order sometime even bail puri for me. I have done that. I'm telling you, that's my experience. The Bombay police is excellent. Don't regard them as bad people. Actually, we human beings are bad. And we should not throw our weight that we are lawyers and I can do this and that. No abusing anybody. See, the police officer has power. The client has committed wrong. He has put it. So talk to the senior man nicely. My lord. Sir, this offense is available and you have the discretion under first and 436. I am therefore invoking your discretion. He'll feel happy. You can't tell him, you should release him. You cannot do that. I will teach you a lesson in the High Court. Okay? Please note that. You have to be very polite to the police officer, even to the humble hawaldar. Please learn humility, which is very important aspect of human life. If it's being humble, you will get orders everywhere. I have been able to, you cannot demand respect, you can only command humility, and your knowledge and power will fetch you a lot of respect. No, I'm telling you. The police officers will tell you, yes, don't worry, it's available, I'll exercise my power. But if you throw your weight around, I will teach you a lesson, go to High Court and Supreme Court, complain to you, the commissioner, he will lose his skill. Go and do what you want. I refuse to exercise my powers. It's human nature, you know, absolute power corrupts absolutely. So why antagonize a man when your both the hands are underneath the rock? Tarse nikale ji usko makkhan nikalte. Okay. So the idea is be nice and tell the police officer. Yeah, because rightly or wrongly, the neighbor was having animosity with them. It's purely a civil matter. Sir, with great respect, the neighbors are fighting together. And my client has been unfortunately arrested. It's a purely a civil matter which can be worked out. Even plea bargain ke andar aap been settle kar sakte hain. In the meanwhile, please exercise your discretion. Grant him bail. He will come as and when you want. I will ensure that he comes to you. Then he'll grant the bail. Okay? Only when the police officer is very adamant, then you go before a magistrate next day morning. Okay? He will also be produced. A magistrate will be happy to grant. But again, before the magistrate, you have to be very humble. My lord, the learned police, don't tell the police officer he doesn't know the law and he is a very bad man. And no, the police, the judges won't like to listen to abuses from a lawyer. Please note that. Judges also expect a lawyer is an officer of the court. You must maintain dignity under the Advocates Act. You should not lose your dignity and you should not identify with your client and don't get antagonized. Please maintain your cool. Pyar se bataiye court ko, my lord, in this matter, the offense is bailable. The discretion which ought to have been exercised by the police officer, they are not done. I am therefore no other alternative. I am before your lordship. Kindly grant bail in this matter. I undertake to abide by all the terms and conditions. Ye kaisa laga? If you are a magistrate, you will grant me bail or not?
Immediately.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir.
Politeness and graciousness. Put up a nice smile and be confident and be well versed in your fact. FIR ko 5-6 baar padh ke jao. Underline the FIR. I was arguing a matter before the Honorable High Court during this pandemic. One of the client who came to me, I will not take his name. He was belonging to a BJP ruling party. He came to me that I am about to be arrested by the police, Bandra police station, on the allegation that I am preventing bodies to be buried in Muslim Kabristan. And the matter came up before the bench of Justice Shaiya Sayyad, who himself is a Muslim. And I simply made them laugh, pointing out, my lord, the two group of Muslims from Bandra East and West are fighting over. And I am purely, I do not know, I am only a social worker. I am being made a scapegoat. I have no role to play. It's being made like this. So ultimately the court granted the case, you know. Be like this, you have to get it done. Whatever may be, you make the judges, make them happy and feel easy and comfortable, they grant the bail to you. That is how it is, situation. Judges are human beings and they don't... them the wrong way. Okay. And now let us come to the powers of the session court and what matters you should go. Now the powers of the session court and high court, section 439 CRPC. So I won't be taking through the act now. Mansi will be able, so all of you must have gone through. In 2 hours time, you will not be able to cover it. Under 439 CRPC, you have a right to move the sessions court in case the magistrate doesn't grant the bail to you in some matters. On certain matters, directly you can move the before the Honorable Session Court where the offense is triable by the Court of Session. Now open kare aap, aapka schedule try kare. There are cases triable by the magistrate. Now take for example 309 Arnav Goswami's case. I will just take it because that is a fresh in everybody's mind. Section 309, na, isn't there? Section 309 open kar lijiye aap 309 is many magistrates sessions go 311 306 abatement for commission of the suicide 306 is a trial which is a trial before the court of session. The relevant provisions, you should remember how the trial before the court of session take place in chapter 18 from section 225 se lekar section 237. Wo CRPC mein yaad rakh liya. At the moment, trial we are not conducting bail. So you should remember this. when the offense itself is triable before a court of magistrate, there are certain judgments of the Delhi High Court and Bombay High Court that the magistrate should not entertain application for bail under 437. It is advisable for the parties to go before the court of session. So please remember that here, you would remember this and make an application before the court of session. So in the city of Bombay, we have court of session do jagah hain. Ek fountain ke andar hai, ek this one, what you call it, and Goregaon mein hai, isn't it? At Goregaon, all offenses which take place from Kolaba to Mahim, they go to the session court at Kalagoda near the city civil court and Bombay High Court. And all offenses taking place from Bandra to Dahisar, they go to Dindoshi court, their court. So before the sessions court, the nomenclature will change here. Before the Honorable Court of Session, Greater Bombay, bail application number so-and-so, name of your client and name of the police station, state of Maharashtra at the instance of CBD, CED, so-and-so. So in the matter of bail, under section 439 CRPC. So the first statement is the applicant is presenting this application before this Honorable Court under the provisions of section 439, the case is triable by the court of session. Mention this. Sometime they may ask you, why have you not gone before magistrate? My lord, there is a judgment of the Bombay High Court and Delhi High Court which say that I am required to come. Because section 437 CRPC does not bar you. In fact, you can go anywhere. It doesn't clarify. But these are judicial precedents which we are required to respect, you know. So when the application is, when the offense is triable by a court of session, please note that your time should not be wasted. Like poor Arnav Goswami was put in custody for 15 days time. Why? Because the lawyer should have moved the application first at the court of session. Next day, he would have been out. Because yeah, the abatement of a suicide of so many days, you cannot put him in jail for so many days. So according to me, with due respect to the great legal luminaries who are equally brilliant, but they are misfired. You know, the application, they took a chance. They went to magistrate who had no jurisdiction. He said, I have no power to grant bail because the offense is triable by the court of session. They chose not to go to session court. They directly moved the high court under Article 226 and 227 and Section 482 CRPC inherent power. That was high court rejected. It was misfired. As a result, so much time is consumed. So your client is required to be in custodial custody, which is rather, it is a non-application of mind on the part of the lawyers. Then ultimately they moved the Supreme Court under Article 136, which is too late. So the poor fellow was, you can see the photograph, he was humiliated by the police. That should not happen. As a young lawyer, you should know where your remedy is, strategy is. Your strategy should be in the right jurisdiction. That is why you should know your CPC, CRPC, Evidence Act by heart, you know, like a Bible. So once you become a lawyer, you become flabbergasted. You will become very confident, overconfident. See, we all tend to forget it. Don't do that. Keep your cool mind. So jurisdiction finding out is very important. Which court has jurisdiction? Which magistrate and which session court is jurisdiction? Civil court can there be? Section 9 tells you where you should go. Section 15 to 22 kehta hai, what are the various forum you must approach? Isn't it? If you go to wrong forum and your suit, you will be non-suited. So you remember the rulings. You remember the section. Section 190 aap barabar padke jayenge CRPC ka, you come to know the original court of jurisdiction and the triable offenses and judgment of their various court. So in a session, in a state of Maharashtra, at least you please note that when an offense is triable by the court of session, if your client is arrested, if he comes to you for bail, don't go to magistrate court. Please note that. Don't go to high court also. High court will say, when is the alternate remedy available, why have you come to me? They will dismiss the application. The existence of alternate remedy should be invoked first. So your alternate remedy is here in cases where the trial take place before the court of session 306 Vara Kendar, move the sessions court Greater Bombay. Session court Kendar, make application. Such and judges are very brilliant. They are district judges. They understand the law very well. See, magistrates are confused in this matter because Alibag magistrate rightly rejected the application. When the trial is in the offense triable by the court of session, why have you come to me? That finding is still there. You please open the net and you'll come to know. There are lots of judgment on that point. Or sometime I can give you when you meet me or help you out when you ask me about it here. So that is not. So that is the application. Same formats which I told you have to apply. I mean, you have firm roots in society. You are not likely to tamper anywhere. The allegations are false, motivated, and you are not committed offense. And you are presumed to be innocent until you are discharged. And you have been implicated falsely. My custodial detention is unwarranted. I am a firm root in society. I am a family man. Exhibit your ration card. Exhibit your passport. I will not run away from the country without the permission of the court. Tell the court, I am an honest citizen, a bona fide citizen who has been falsely implicated. There are many cases your neighbors want to take action against you, teach you a lesson. Property koi dispute hai andar karao, saale ko police mein pehchane hamare. So waisa bhi hota hai. So immediately you will get the bail. The judges are very, very, I would say that they are also human beings. They are sober people. They are very kind. They are very kind people if you approach them correctly and with the right approach. And if you go to wrong direction, you cannot be barking a wrong tree. And going before a magistrate and in a case tribal by court of session has no meaning. You have wasted your 6-7 time. So remember, this is because lack of understanding of the CRPC and the judgment of the court which are given. If I were the lawyer of Arunav Goswami, I would have directly moved the court of session and not the sessions court or high court or the Supreme Court. I would have saved the time of my client. That is very unfortunate. I do not want to cast aspersion. We all human beings, we all make mistakes. Sometimes I also make mistakes. Judges make mistakes. That is why when I told you that here, in the matter of recording secondary evidence, how many benches of the Supreme Court mistakes? Ultimately, the 3-bench judgment in the month of January, they settled the issue. We all are human beings. Now, concession court grants.
Sir, on this note, I would like to ask you or rather request you to point out some cases wherein due to fuss of the lawyer, the bail has been rejected.
I do not want to blame my young lawyers, my friends and seniors, whoever it is. We'll discuss some other time. I will cover the first bail aspect. Okay. Suppose your application is rejected by the court of session. Allow me to have little water because my gala is now getting dry. Okay.
please, sir, have a sip of water.
I'll have one sip of water. Thank you.
Please, sir.
Yeah, assuming for the sake of argument, your application has been rejected by the learned magistrate under section 437, then you need not file an appeal. It's an interlocutory order, no appeal lies. Please note that. Against interlocutory order, no appeal lies. There's a provision to file an application under section 439. If magistrate rejects you, second bail application will go before the learned session judge. If the learned session judge rejects it, you have to come before the High Court under section 439. High Court ko power hai. Again, bail application. There is no need to file revision, appeal, zarutim. Interlocutory orders mein, there is no provision for bail or there is no need to go in for revision. There's a specific remedy available to you. Okay? And suppose, for example, ye ho gaya, these are the offenses where you are implicated either before the magistrate or in bailable offenses before the police or bailable or non-bailable offenses triable by the magistrate and non-bailable offenses triable by the learned session judge. So yeah, the scheme of the CRPC, you should be very much familiar of where the offenses take place. Okay, now come to anticipatory bail. Anticipatory bail, section 413, even before you're arrested. Now, I ask you, anticipatory bail has become a fashion. Why? Because you are a very powerful political leader or a rich businessman doing very well. Even relation between husband and wife, spouse are strained. Sabse pehle dhamki degi aapki wife or husband, I will teach you a lesson. 498A will be invoked, you will be arrested. What is that? 498A is a strong weapon for women. And man bhi kya bolega, I will teach you a father lesson. I will teach him lesson. Arrested in cheating case. I had given him a sum of rupees, 10 lakh rupees, he never returned to me. Yeh sab cheeze hoenge because anti a political figure. A party, B party, election time are They want to teach a lesson, run down each other. The democracy mein hota hamari, it's a very facade. It's unfortunate. You know that every day if you open up the book and the Supreme Court is granting, High Court granting some bail, rejecting rightly or wrongly in some cases. And today we learned that Mr. Kocher got the bail from the court for financial irregularities in that particular bank. You can see the today's paper, earlier shot of the wife was denied. So anticipatory bail is a bail where you approach the court in anticipation that I am likely to be arrested in some kind of non-bailable offenses. Offenses must be non-bailable and cognizable. I mean, cognizable means where the police officer has a right to arrest without a warrant. And non-bailable are enshrined, you see the schedule mein likha gaya hai uske andar. In bailable offenses, anticipatory bail can't be granted. Oh, bolenge, court bolenge, go before the police. Magistrate, why you want? There is no apprehension of arrest. Only on apprehension is looming large on the horizon, and you are likely to be arrested in non-bailable offenses. The jurisdiction is only given to the session court and the high court. This is supposed to be a concurrent jurisdiction. I mean, parties can simultaneously either go to session court or high court. But our Bombay High Court doesn't like the idea of people going directly first. Bolenge, session court mein jaiye na, brother, first. You take your chance and we will have the opportunity of seeing the order and they grant you accordingly. Why you want to come to high court directly? Why you want to miss your one inning? Second inning ke liye idhar aaiye, third inning Supreme Court. So that is a good advice according to me, isn't it? So you first go to the court of sessions. Magistrates court do not have power to grant bail, anticipatory bail. Please note that the executive magistrate cannot entertain any application for any bail. Please note that judicial magistrate can entertain bail application under 436 and 437. So anticipatory bail jurisdiction powers are given to only the court of sessions, Greater Bombay in Mumbai, and the Honorable High Court Bombay. And elsewhere is the same situation, the High Court. So, what kind of allegations you are required to make? What is the material you required and before the court? Number one, police officer aapko 161 ke liye notice bhejega. 161, you know that statements to be recorded. There must be an FIR. Now, there are some judgments which say that there need not be FIR to apply for an anticipatory bail. A mere apprehension of arrest is there in your mind, is lurking, looming large on the horizon. Or you have a fear that tomorrow political opponent, your neighbor, your friend, your brother, somebody who is having animosity with you, aapko andar karne wala hai. Police officer se tie up, he's colluding with him and having good relation. You can approach the court of sessions and high court. First preference, you go to sessions court, placing a record before the court, my lord, before the honorable court of session, Greater Bombay. Next mein aayega anticipatory bail application number ABA bolte hai isko, anticipatory bail application number blank of 2001. Write your name as applicant and the state of Maharashtra, so and so police station, as whoever you are apprehending, whichever police station, you can club everything, or commissioner of police, so and so. Right side mein likhenge aap in the matter of section 438 CRPC. Okay, judge sab samajh jayenge what it is. 438 judges are knowledgeable people, enlightened people, they don't know it. So then in the matter of before the honorable principal judge, to the honorable principal judge and all other principal honorable companion judges of this honorable court, the humble application of the applicant above him, most respectfully shred. So this is the normal nomenclature which has been being used from the date of the British times or Mughal times. And it is still continued this practice, and there's a way you give respect to judges, okay? To the honorable principal judge and the other companion judges of this honorable court, the humble application of the applicant above him, a most respectfully shwet. Shwet comes up as seeking prayers. So then you mention the name of the client. Now, I so and so, the applicant above him, do hereby solemnly affirm and state as under solemn affirmation. Aapko court mein aana padega, since you are out of bail and this application should be presented by you and your presence is now mandatory in the court. Likhenge aap, the applicant is making the present application seeking anticipatory bail, invoking the powers of your lordship or this honorable court under section 438 CRPC in the facts and circumstances stated hereunder. Or you may say, in order to appreciate the controversy in the matter, the applicant would like to give a brief narration of fact, which is as under. You may say that the applicant is conducting business in partnership with Mr. XYZ. The relationship between the applicant and his partners are strained over financial matters. The applicant has filed a suit or likely to file a suit in the Honorable High Court, Bombay, or City Civil Court, or before the arbitration panel invoking arbitration for dissolution of the firm. He has committed flagrant violations, and on the contrary, he is laying a counterclaim. He has opened bank account and he is blaming me, but he has gone abroad. Some disputes narration of fact. So in short, the relationship between the applicant and his business partners are considerably strained. As a result whereof, the partner of the applicant, who is an influential man connected with politician, he yields high degree of influence with the police and the politician. And he has been threatening me that unless and until I deposit in his account a sum of rupees 5 crore, 10 crore, I have recorded in my telephone. You may say that record, that can mean evidence now. Under the provisions of Section 65BA of the Evidence Act, it's an evidence which can be used against him. You can play in the court if need be. So I have an apprehension, and as a result thereof, I am receiving a notice from the EOW of Bombay. And EOW want to interrogate me in the matter. I have an apprehension that EOW, with whom he has got high influence, they will arrest me. So you have taken the advice from your lawyer. The lawyer will tell you EOW has wide power. Section 41 ke andar aapko dal dega pat karke. I am ready to go there, but my apprehension that I should not be arrested. So if sir, I am arrested, sir, my reputation. Ji boliye, boliye.
Sir, is it desirable that a lawyer should mention this in his petition or application that the police has like hands in gloves with the accused?
No.
And so
no, aisa nahi bolna padega. How you said it, he is the respondent, the person with whom he is claiming that he has got high influence. Yeah, he is claiming that he has got high influence, and he has stated that he will teach me a lesson. Okay. Everything is his version, not your version. Aap samjhe? It is not your direct evidence, it is a hearsay evidence. So hearsay evidence is not admissible under the evidence.
Yes,
side.
Yes, huh? Yes.
So
yes,
I am trying to escape you and your client. This is what you heard. He gave me threats. Yeah. He gave me threats. That is what I'm telling you. He is threatening me. He's my neighbor. He had come to the office. Court bolenge, did you record it? Phone pe nahi, ghar mein aake personally dekhe gaya. Isn't it? I went and lodged a complaint to the police station. So police is not taking. The police is turning a Nelson's eye, because the police seems to be, the other day I went and found he was having a cup of tea with the police inspector. Huh?
Yes, sir. Okay.
So you in that girl, what you call it, the father and mother who killed the girl, what is the case name? Mukherjee, Banerjee, Panerjee ka naam hai?
Talwar case.
No, not Talwar.
Sheena Bora case.
Sheena Bora's case mein kya ho gaya? The police commissioner himself going to the police station and recording statement, which is shocking. It doesn't happen, isn't it? A police commissioner of Bombay himself is recording statement without deputing it to the senior inspector of police, who is normally in the investigation officer. Aap samjhe na aap?
Rakesh Maria the na, sir. Tab.
Well, sir, yes.
But there don't is a take, provision in CRPC it, that he it, himself can conduct the investigation.
See, no, I am telling you, I don't take names. This is how, because if the police commissioner himself is taking interest in the matter, then you can see that there is something iske andar dal mein kala zarur hai, isn't it? Then everything
but
has come,
sir,
out here.
But sir, right, there is a provision in the CRPC that the superior officer can take investigation in
his
hand.
My dear madam, it is all CRPC, IPC is all flouted when it comes to money, color and power. Sanjana, it is only when rules are flouted that people go to court, isn't it? Tell me, Why would people go?
Nothing wrong.
Nothing wrong. Normally, under the Bombay Police Act, you don't do that. There are hierarchy. Samjana? There's a hierarchy. Like you cannot approach the Supreme Court directly when you have a civil matter tribal by the court of small causes court, cities you will go. Can you jump directly to the Supreme Court? There is a jurisdiction aspect. Similarly, a senior most officer, a police commissioner will not come down to all the way our police station to investigate the crime. So in such matters, so when you applied for bail, you other side will not get it. Samjana Apil? So you means you can take up the plea that yeah, the police officers are pally with the other side. Yeah, they're very pally with him. So I am likely to be arrested pally? If I go and pally matlab dosti, dostana, yarana. Very pally, P-L-L. Pally matlab ke, you know, closeness, fraternity, ekdam. Pyar mohabbat zyada hai police mein aur accused mein, complainant ke andar. Samjha na abhi? As a result, whereof you will be taught a lesson, your client. Samjha na? So I'm apprehending an arrest in this matter. Apprehension is looming large. You may ask, session judge will ask you, what is the urgency? My lord, I am likely to be arrested. My reputation will be tarnished. I'm a honest, successful businessman. I have high esteem in society's view. Everybody knows me. And they are trying their best to get me arrested. Isn't
sir,
it?
Can you also say that you'll be arrested and be given third degree?
Yeah, third degree, everything. If you are arrested, they will teach you a lesson. And why in TRP cases many journalists are rushing to court for anticipatory bail? Somebody is trying to call me. Yeah. Isn't it? In TRP cases, some cases the courts are granting bail. Some cases the courts are rejecting. Let the investigation take place. In deserving cases, the courts are granting bail. So, it's all vindictiveness. For TRP, ke liye bhi journalists kuch bhi kar rahe hain. And in fact, in the case of Kasap's case, which I dealt yesterday, you may see that the Supreme Court Justice Aftab Alam and Justice Prasad have passed strictures against the Indian media. What are you recording, live recording of this criminal man, Tessir? You are trying to wipe out the evidence. You are trying to alarm everybody. You should be done. The man is killing everybody on live showing. Just for the sake of aggrandizing, improving your TRP business commercial, you do not have the interest of the society. You cannot do a police officer next day in the morning, anything happens, comes in the newspaper and gives statement, accuse me, bola, oh bola. They cannot do that. You cannot divulge the information like this. The investigation has to be secretive. Then only you can reach. Why the conviction rate is so poor in our country? Conviction rate is abysmal. 1%, 2%, shame. Why the police officers are not performing their duty? 90% cases are out people on account of shoddy investigation. With due respect, the police officers, they are under the, under deep pressure from various factors. They slaves of the political masters. That is why the investigations are not correct here, defaulty. So how do you record conviction? The conviction rate is very poor. A children and women's matter mein, kitne offenses hote hain iske andar? You know that here, Juvenile Delinquencies Act, and how many convictions in 498? Hardly any. So this is all on account of poor investigation. Now the Tabasco Burners case, which I quoted to you while dealing with the provisions of the secondary evidence, how the police officers in Varanasi conducted poor investigation, CC camera TV available in the hotel, and you are not recording who came and committed the murder. There were three people, all Italians, one gallant boy, and the other going to die. And they came and informed the police. And what happened to him? He was feeling fever. He must have died, something like that. That the report came, he died up at the court. The police officer, the CCTV camera report. CCTV camera will reveal everything. What kind of investigation this is? The strictures have been passed by Justice Supreme Court held that that judgment is par in quorum, having not considered the earlier judgment of the Supreme Court in Anwar's case with a 3-bench judgment, which get guidelines are laid down. So that is a different issue aspect here. So when you make an anticipated application before the court, you show before the court what is the apprehension, how you are likely to be arrested, what is the offense you are likely to be charged in, number one. It is the Supreme Court now says that some judgments of the court, unfortunately, the session judge will ask you, is there a FIR? There is no need to have FIR to get you arrested. The police is exercising the power of arrest without FIR. Now, Dalita Kumari's judgment, are they following in the Supreme Court? Are they in India? In Dalita Kumari's judgment, 5-bench judgments are strictly laid down. When first information is reported, is like you must, when a complaint is given, you must lodge a FIR. Kahan pe lodge karte hain? And when you sought to be arrested right off bail, Kapoor's case, the Supreme Court laid guidelines. So the guidelines are given a go by, unfortunately. But as a young lawyer, when you go before the court, be armed with fully all this. There are judgments you read for everything, there are judgments. The judgment, so many high courts we have got in India, 26 high courts we have got, and Supreme Court ke judgment. And judgments are where will help you out, because CPC, CRPC, a plain act may not help you out. Even if you read the old books, you are an overruled judgment. Keep reading newspapers and every day, and maintain a diary and keep recording it. This is the day the judgment came, and so on. So you will be a good lawyer. It has been my practice from the day one. I take out the newspaper cutting and keep it. Or write it down in a newspaper. I got a book, A, B, C, D, wise, and write it down. A for arrest, B for bail, C for charge sheet, aise likhte the hum. I for injunction and all. I still have maintained from the year 1980, I maintained the book. And it is still there. As a young, of course, you don't need to maintain this because your computer system is very well and you just click on it, you get it. You're lucky. For me, Mansi has been very grateful. I'm grateful to her. Every time I take lecture, she comes and puts it on the display board. It'll come. That's why I requested the management that Mansi Bhushan be today taken on record, and she will do a good job.
Special thanks to Mansi.
Yes. Yeah. So this is this scenario. So you make in the application a special case make out. What is the apprehension? What is the apprehension of arrested? And the charges must be non-bailable. I am likely to be arrested under the provisions of Section 420 CPC, IPC, which is a cheating, or Section 406 and 409, a breach of trust, where breach of trust, which are punishable for 10 years and life imprisonment, 409, you know that, nah? And they may also invoke other charges of forgery, 467, which is also life imprisonment. So, Your Lordship, this is a serious matter. They want to teach me a lesson. I am an income tax payee. I have no incriminating records against me. There are no previous conviction against me. I have not been so far implicated. I undertake to abide by the direction of the Honorable Court and fully cooperate with the EOW or any police agencies. I am not running away from here. This is my passport. I have firm roots in society. I am a family man. And I may kindly be enlarged on bail in the event of my arrest. Yeah, I may be enlarged. The police station may be directed to release me on bail in the event of my arrest on such terms and conditions that this Honorable Court may impose in the facts and circumstances and such for the Honorable. In the interest of justice, equity, and good conscience, this Honorable Court be pleased to pass this order. Okay, this is the anticipatory bail, which you take it, file it out in the before the court of sessions, and in the court of session reject, or even concurrently, some of the high court says you can move the high court directly. Suppose if you are arrested by a Delhi police or a Meghalaya police in Bombay, and you cannot go to session court, they are no jurisdiction. You are required to move the high court for a transit bail. It is called kya bolte? Anybody knows? Transit bail. Have you heard of this word? Hello, I am audible?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes. Transit anticipatory bail mean the Bombay High Court will grant you only 1 or 2 weeks bail that one of the students from Delhi and Kerala passed an allegation against the farmers. You know that, yeah? She was thought to be arrested by Delhi police. The police came to Bombay all the way. The Bombay High Court granted bail to many people, the Madras High Court, everywhere. So every day you're reading this in the newspaper, people are likely to be arrested. A different police come from different state. Normally under Article 226, 227, the High Court has jurisdiction primarily within the territorial jurisdiction of the state. But the High Court has power, because 226 may, the High Court can also set aside the central government legislation. All of you know that in the first year law, you must have learned it yet. So the High Court will grant you temporary bail. It is also known as transit bail, with a direction that after 20 days, ke baad, you may continue your bail in the appropriate state where the High Court is situated, or Session Court is situated. So Bombay High Court ne bail de diya aapko, then Delhi ke session jana hai aap. So Delhi mein Session Court mein jaake bail aapko renew kar lijiye aap. Okay? That is easy. Once the court grants you bail here, that's a transit bail application, different police. So the Bombay Delhi ke police, okay, that is how it is. Then another, yes, boliye.
Sir, what if police deliberately does not investigate the matter properly, and then thereafter charge sheet is filed wherein evidence is also not considered properly, then what is the recourse being the prosecution, being the victim?
If the police has not done proper job, then you can move the court that prosecution agency be changed. Okay? You can tell that the CBD, CID may be appointed. You can tell. Because when the charge sheet is filed, you cannot go. This is at the charge sheet is filed under section 173 CRPC. And under 207, copies are given to the accused person. And under 209, the committal proceeding to the court of session. So at that time, before the police officer investigate, investigation starts from section 156 onwards. So that is the stage you come to know investigation sahi line pe ja raha hai, nahi ja raha hai. Are they collecting proper evidence? The police officer, suppose the cases of 306 death camera, somebody can attempt to commit suicide. Whether the police officer has recorded the statements of people who were around. Number one, inquest panchanama has been recorded under section 174 CRPC. As a young lawyer, you should be curious. You should know what is 174. In every death case, attempt to murder case, they had to record. The reason must be given how the murderer or suicide is committed. If 174 is not followed, section 176 CRPC may, the magistrate can conduct investigation and appoint another magistrate to hold the inquiry. So your powers are there. You have remedies. See, when a police officer under section 154, 176, kaam nahi kar raha hai aapko. So you make an application to the magistrate. You please, I want magisterial inquiry. Samjana? Magisterial inquiry. When you open section 176, bataunga aapko main. Da khol lijiye abhi. CRPC, Mansi, please khol lijiye. 174 and 176 khol lijiye. Pahle 174 mein aa jaiye. Police to inquire about the report of the suicide, etc. It is the duty of the police to, suppose Kushan Singh has committed a suicide. 174 can the police has to conduct the investigation report. Agar police nahi kari, you please come to 176. Inquiry by magistrate into cause of death. So the learned magistrate will hold inquiry. So CRPC is a very comprehensive act here. You can take action. Then the Bombay Police Act, the Police Act in India, inquiry karne ke liye, you can make application. You can transfer the cases, you go to Supreme Court and High Court. There are so many FIRs here. Section 406, how the CRPC can the power of the court to transfer cases here. 406, 407, 408. I know 406 mein the Supreme Court can transfer the appeal. 407 mein High Court can transfer it. And 408 ke andar Court of Session Court can transfer it. 410 ke andar Session Magistrate ko power hai. So there are vast provisions in CRPC. Isliye bolta hu main, please go through the act very well, remember them. You may not exactly by heart the words. Like I am able to lay my hand, you can also lay it. If I can lay, you will definitely lay better, because I come from a vernacular medium, Telugu medium. You must be from good English medium, from good schools, better than me. I came from a Zilla Parishad school. I remember many things. But you must be coming from a prestigious school. You will be better than me 1,000 times. And I'm sure you are a better student and you will be a better lawyer. If I can do something, and you will do better than me. I am confident. Only have confidence in yourself. Work hard. There is no substitute for hard work. And I will tell you all, I am teaching in the government law college for the last 30 years. I am only BA LLB. Mansi and other students asked me, sir, how come you have not done LLM, PhD? I felt it is not necessary for me. I believe in only basic qualification. In our days, we were taken demonstration. In the demonstration, I was selected. I told them one of them asked me, why have you not done LLM and LLB? I told them, Lord, I can do it, but my handwriting is not legible. The examiner will give me 0. Though I remember everything, I can come top on the oral examination, but I will not be able to score marks because I am handicapped in writing. So I clearly said, they laughed at me, yes, we are selecting you because your delivery was good. That is how it is. So you don't have to worry about it. So remember these sections very well. You don't have to by heart them. And remember, have a cursory glance. CPC, CRP, they are very beautifully balanced report. Of course, the act is haphazardly drafted by the legislature as usual other acts, but you should be able to place your hand. So when the police officer you think is not doing his duty properly, you have a right to report to magistrate. You have to come to the magistrate court, session court, high court. Don't worry. There are lots of remedies available to you. Okay? Everybody is accountable in our system. Our constitution is a beautifully drafted document. CPC, CRP, all our legislations are beautifully drafted. According to me, our constitution is the best document. I have read all throughout all the world's various constitution. I found India's constitution to be supreme and number one. Beautifully, it's a beautiful product. According to me. So read it here. Remember the provisions of the salient features of the Indian constitution, how legislation takes place, how system, there is answer for each and every one. So in our topic, anticipatory bail, you have to justify your apprehension, why you are being arrested, and show before the court you are ready and willing to abide by terms and conditions. Okay? Anybody want to ask any question? Please do that.
Yes, sir. So my question is pertaining to transit bail. So how do we apply for transit bail? Is the application process similar to a anticipatory bail?
Yeah. Just note down. In the Bombay High Court, you make it here. Before in the High Court of Judicature at Bombay. In the High Court of Judicature at Bombay. In its criminal appellate jurisdiction. Criminal appellate jurisdiction. In the matter of Article 226, 227, and Section 482 CRPC. 226 is High Court jurisdiction, 227 Supreme jurisdiction, 482 are the inherent power. Okay? And in the matter of Delhi Police so-and-so, the order of so-and-so arrest. To the Honorable Chief Justice, you put your name as the petitioner and the name of the respondent will be Union of India, Delhi, so-and-so. And state of Maharashtra also join a party. Then start with to the Honorable Chief Justice and the other companion judges of this Honorable High Court. The humble application of the applicant above him most respectfully shall be done. Number one, the applicant petitioner is a citizen of India. Okay, make it, because citizens you mentioned it here. Then the respondents are the state or agencies or instrumentality of the state within the meaning of Article 12 of the Constitution of India, and as such amenable to the writ orders of this Honorable Court. The subject matter of present petition is that the petitioner, who is a citizen of Mumbai, inhabitant of Mumbai, is sought to be illegally arrested by Delhi police, and he received communication from Delhi on so and so date that I have been summoned to appear before the Delhi. I have grave apprehension. The petitioner had raised certain disputes and voice certain concern about the farmers' agitation, which is not appreciated by the authorities concerned. It appears in vengeance, they are likely to get me arrested. matter. I have apprehension. By the time I go to Delhi, I will be arrested. If I go to the airport, I'll be arrested in this matter in order to protect my fundamental rights under Article 21 of the Constitution of India and Article 22 of the Constitution. This Honorable Court, be pleased to protect me for a limited period until I go to Delhi court and secure appropriate bail from a competent court in Delhi. It is therefore humbly pled that this Honorable Court be pleased to issue a writ of mandamus and a writ of prohibition. Mandamus directing the Delhi police and the media and the state of days, 20 days, 30 days, or such people, I may be directed, for which act of kindness the shall remain grateful to this Honorable Court. Then verification likhiye, I so and so the petitioner have owned do hereby, and what has been stated here, true to my knowledge and belief, save and accept the legal submission, which are an information I believe the same to be true. Okay, aapka petition tayar ho gaya, and small affidavit, supporting affidavit, I so and so true, and this Honorable Court be, for the reason mentioned therein, this Honorable Court be pleased to invoke your powers under Article 226, 27, 482, grant me the relief and issue a rule nicely and dispose of the matter as early as possible. Aapka petition tayar ho gaya. Okay, any question, please ask.
Sir, it is to be written that in the matter of and transit bail along with 226 and yes,
somebody is calling me. I'll just call you. I'll take 1 minute. Sorry, somebody was bothering me with the telephone. I just told him, don't call me. I'm in a lecture. Yeah. Sorry. What is your question?
I said, is it required to write in the matter of transit bail, those words?
Not necessary. The court may ask. You have to mention, no? At least it is. Yeah. You may mention that here that you are citizen of India. The court will ask you, when the Delhi police has come, why have you made? It is better to mention. Are you losing anything? Temporary bail. Is a temporary bail. It is better to go in the matter of transit bail. In the matter of request for transit bail. That will be clear in the mind of a judge. It will be better. The judge should not be confused. Waste his time. The matter is going to his house and the judges are burning the lamp the last minute, and you can reduce the tension. Judge should not read the entire petition. Your synopsis must contain. See, your synopsis will be just one or two pages. Short mail. Number, you are citizen of India. You have spoken against the farmer's litigation or some dispute, and you are likely to be arrested. And by the time you go to Delhi, it is not possible for you. Transit bail may be granted. I undertake to
apply. Sir, another question in this, that
one page
bail application or anticipated bail application should always be drafted in first person.
By?
Or it may be...
Yes. It should be drafted by the person because it's available. No? Advocate himself cannot...
Drafted in first person, I mean to say that I, so-and-so...
The petitioner should be applicant. The applicant. I name.
Okay.
It is applicant.
Is the petitioner applicant.
The applicant or the petitioner. The petitioner is a citizen of India or the applicant, because the applicant makes the application. Okay. Will be under Article 226, 227. Such applications are normally heard by the Bombay High Court by division bench. When division bench not available, single judge hears it. Okay.
For transit bail directly to the High Court, we can approach.
High Court, you have to approach, because there is a different state. It's a different police station in the same state.
Interstate.
If it interstate, and it's the same state and different districts in Maharashtra, then you can also move the court of sessions. Suppose you are sought to be arrested by Pune police, you can go to the court of sessions in Bombay. Samjhana aap?
Okay.
Because this will be under within the state of Maharashtra.
Yes, sir.
Hierarchy you will come to know. So try to read the Police Act also. Huh? Police Act ko samajh jaiye, because you are not being taught the Police Act. Police Act ke andar sab likha gaya hai. Okay. This is the civil criminal matter. I will now briefly take some. What is the time now, Mansi? How much?
Sir, it's almost
7:30. Now another half an hour we got, no? Only half an hour we got?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now I will draft one civil case to you.
Sir, sorry to interrupt. Would you like to check once whether your Wi-Fi is connected?
My Wi-Fi is not connected. I think it's connected. I'll check. I'll just check it. Nazish, oh Nazish, Nazish, idhar aaiye Wi-Fi idhar nahi chal raha hamara.
I request the co-host to pause the recording.
Is it okay? Is it okay now, Mansi? Are you able to hear me? Just guess you want. Which court? High court you want? City civil court you want? Bombay High Court you want? Small causes court you want? But I, because one or two, we have got half an hour. I will try to take up one small plate of each court now.
Whichever gives.
Now we'll start with the we'll start with the lowest court. I will take one small causes court, one city court, one high court. Now landlord and tenant disputes they come to the high court, both under the Maharashtra Rent Control Act, under the Presidency Small Causes Court Act. Okay, those who are protected under the Rent Act, they come under the Maharashtra Rent Control Act. Jurisdiction is Section 33. And those tenant, landlord and tenant who are not protected under the Rent Act, they come under Section 41 of the Presidency Small Cost Court Act. Like banks, schools and colleges and companies having a turnover of more capital of 1 crore and above, and those lease lessees whose license, whose lease has been expired, they come under Section 41. Okay, remember this. So I will give you two planes. So first plane will be a landlord wanting to file a suit for bona fide requirement or non-payment of rent. In the Small Causes Court, Bombay, you had to have the landlord can only evict a tenant when he has the ground of eviction. Those grounds are given under Section 15, that is a forfeiture clause, non-payment of rent, for which you had to give a notice under Section 106, TP Act. Then Section 16, 1 A, B, C, D, E, F, J, H, Tech, those sections, such as a tenant has violated the terms of tenancy, bona fide requirement, nuisance, various ground, notice of termination is not required. In view of the Supreme Court judgment in Dhanpal Chettiar versus Yashoda Maheske, that is a 1973 Supreme Court, 1745. You know that here. You must have gone through your second year. Your professors must have told you. So I will now take up a case. Now here, now Section 15, check kar lijiye aap. I will club both Section 15 and 16 together. Your contention is that here your tenant has not paid you rent for 1 year. And at the same time, your family is growing. You require the premises for your own use and occupation. It may be residential or commercial. Dono ke liye, there's no difference. Okay? Then you may take up the plea that the tenant has sublet the premises without your permission. Under the Rent Act, after 1/2/1973, you cannot sublet the premises. Oh, provision. Then the nuisance and annoyance is Section 16(1)(c). Tenant is harboring a lot of animals, like rakha hai, awazein ho rahe, ganda rakha hai, or is planting explosives and all. It is a nuisance of the highest order. You can evict it. So the plaint will be, now Section 15 says that here, if you want to evict a tenant for non-payment of rent, you have to give a notice of termination under 106 TP Act. So termination notice is when I hereby, you place on record, you are my tenant in respect of flat number, shop number, so-and-so, for so-and-so, for a rent of so-and-so. This is to inform you that you have failed and neglected to pay the rent for a period of 1 month for reason best known to you, and you are liable to be evicted. I therefore hereby terminate your tenancy with immediate effect, and you are hereby called upon to quit, vacate, hand over quiet, vacant, peaceful possession, and hand over to me within a period of, after the expiration of the 1 month from the date of this notice. Aapki notice tayar ho gayi. Okay. Now, after 1 month ke baad, plain tayar kijiye aap. In the Court of Small Causes Court, Bombay, RAE suit, Rent Act Eviction suit. Our rent rahega to RAE and R suit, Rent Act and Recovery of Rent suit. Okay. The landlord is filing it. If you are filing a suit on behalf of for evicting your bank and multinational company, they will be known as TE suit, means tenant eviction suit, under Section 41 of the Presidency Small Cost Code. So, TE suit ke liye bhi aapko 106 notice dena padega. It is mandatory. Because unless otherwise the law mandates, termination notice is not necessary. Earlier, prior to Dhanpal Chettiar's case, termination notice was mandatory under 106. ना दंपल चट्टिया देख लीजिए आप बाद में घर पे जाके tenant eviction suit, tenant at sufferance. Tenant at sufferance is either tenant, a person whose lease has expired by efflux of time or after termination, a bank was your lessee for 5 years or your petrol pump ko aapne jagah diya tha, petrol pump, you want to evict them, you want the premises. A land was given to a tenant, a land is not protected under the Rent Control Act. Samjhna aap? तो उसके लिए टी सूट बिकॉज टेनेंट एट सफरेंस अंडर द टीपी एक्ट से क्या पे व्हेन टेनेंसी इज डिटरमिन अंडर 103 टीपी एक्ट द टेनेंट स्टेटस बिकम्स टेनेंट एट सफरेंस मीन अ पर्सन हैविंग नो राइट एट इंटरेस्ट सी इज लायबल टू बी इविक्टेड यू कैन नॉट थ्रो हिम आउट ओपनली हाथ से जाके यू हैव टू फाइल अ इविक्शन सूट सो इन द कोर्ट ऑफ स्मॉल कॉसेस कोर्ट बॉम्बे पुट योर नेम एज अ लैंडलॉर्ड प्लेंटिफ एंड डिफेंडेंट विल बी डिफेंडेंट कंपनी टेनेंट का नाम डिफेंडेंट Then plaint ke andar start physiria may the plaintiff upon him stayed as under. That is how. First description of yourself. Plaintiff is the landlord and owner in respect of property so and so. Give full description. Tenant, the defendant is a tenant or a tenant at sufferance of the plaintiff in respect of the following premises. Give full description. Full description dijiye aap. Then the said premises are here now to refer to for the sake of brevity to as the suit premises. वो लिखेंगे आप and here to annex mark exhibit A is the plan a rough sketch showing the full description of the premises. This will enable order six rule 1 and 2 tells you description should be given because at the time when a decree is passed you should be given property by the bailiff. वो लिखे non description of the property your suit property will not be given. लिखने का south के अंदर ये है north के अंदर इसके बाजू में ये है and east ke andar ye hai west ke andar full description of the property you must be just close it that is very important the present suit is being filed against the defendant for committing breaches under the provisions of rent act for having not paid rent for more than 3 years specify the period he has rendered himself liable to be evicted the plaintiff has given notice of termination under 106 on so and so date here to annex mark exhibit A is a copy of the notice The said notice was duly served upon him and upon the defendant. Here to annex mark exhibit XYZ is the copy of no service effected upon him. Defendant replied and not replied. He replied, he gave a reply. The reply of the defendant is very vague, unsustainable in the eyes of law. I have given rejoinder, my rejoinder, exhibit karo pura court ke andar. In view of the fact that the explanation of the defendant being unsatisfactory, and not ready and willing to pay he is liable to be evicted from the premises he should be directed to quit vacate hand over quiet vacant peaceful possession then without prejudice to the aforesaid contention the plaintiff further submit that the defendant has committed acts of waste and damage to the premises by breaking open the wall he has constructed grills he has constructed mori he has constructed so and so and changed the room rain and damaged the property and which is in contravention of the provisions of section 108 clause o of the tp act isn't it and he is liable to be evicted and the provisions of section 16a and b aap rent act mein padhenge aap sikh jayenge aap okay it's very easy nothing to worry so the tenant is liable to be evicted if he is a causing nuisance for tenant is no breeding and he is fostering so many animals and they are making huge noise they are dirtying the place complaints have been lodged to police I also informed the police station, municipal corporation took action, prosecution is pending. And complaint, neighbors are complaining, I am receiving letters from first floor, second floor, third floor neighbors. So almost every day life has become miserable. It is impossible to live in the premises where I am residing and tenants, their life is impossible. The peace and tranquility in the premises is totally destroyed. And hence the defendant is liable to be evicted for causing nuisance and annoyance to the plaintiff if he is staying or to the neighbors, immediate neighbors who have complained here to annex mark exhibit XYZ, YFGH are the letters of the neighbors and here to annex mark exhibit so into the criminal prosecution started by the BMC and here to annex the police action taken. Sab ko exhibit kar, because under the provisions of order 7, rule 11, order 7, rule 14 CPC, the plaintiff must exhibit all the document rely upon. If he doesn't do, he will not be permitted to lead evidence except documents meant for cross examination he need not disclose isn't it after purchase of cpc I need not tell you all this तो ये डॉक्यूमेंट लिखना पड़ेगा, लिस्ट ऑफ डॉक्यूमेंट डाल दीजिए आप, डालने के बाद देन यू मेंशन द सूट, यू नो रेंट एक्ट में सूट इज लायबल टू बी फाइल्ड विद इन अ पीरियड ऑफ 12 इयर्स अंडर आर्टिकल 66 67 ऑफ द लिमिटेशन एक्ट. ओके, लिमिटेशन एक्ट को मत भूलिए. रिमेंबर दिस, फर्स्ट यू मस्ट रिमेंबर व्हाट इज द लिमिटेशन पीरियड, आर्टिकल 66, 12 इयर्स एक्शन. इफ यू डोंट टेक एक्शन फॉर विद इन दिस 12 इयर्स फॉर इविक्शन, सूट इज बैड. Then various ground, the plaintiff requires the premises reasonably and bona fide for his own use and occupation. Mention karo, give particulars, family is increasing, business is expanding, defendant is a rich man, he can afford to buy 10 premises, why should he be my tenant now anymore? He has lost protection, I have financial hardship he doesn't have, I am not in a position to buy premises where he has got, and he owns several properties, he can easily be, he should not be. In Delhi, the provision is that if the rent is for more than 3,000 rupees, and there is no protection. In Bombay city, is not like that here. The different states have different variation. So ultimately, mention karne ke baad limitation clause aa gaya aapka. Then you mention jurisdiction. Jurisdiction mein kya aayega uske andar? The subject matter of dispute falls within the ambit of Rent Act, Section 23. Relationship of landlord and tenant. And this honorable court has exclusive jurisdiction to entertain and try the present suit. If the property is situated in Bombay from Colaba to Mahim, it will go to small causes court at Dhobi Talao. From Bandra to Dhaisal, go to small causes court at Bandra. That's called BB. वहाँ पे file होता है. Then suit limitation period mentioned किया आपने. Jurisdiction clause, list of document, prayer will be number one. That this honorable court, that the plaintiff therefore pray A. That this honorable court be pleased to order and decree. Mention the word, underline the word decree. Order and decree the defendant to quit vacate. Hand over quiet, vacant, peaceful possession of the premises, namely as described in the exhibit A. Pura premises ko describe kijiye. Then prayer B, that the defendant be ordered and directed to pay mean profit, because from the date of termination his possession becomes illegal occupant. Why should he not pay you mean profit? So he should be ordered and decreed to pay mean profit at the market rate. And for which purpose this honorable court be pleased to institute inquiry under order 12, order 20, rule 12 CCPC. Oh, court karega. That is the duty of the court. Okay, number C.
Sir, quick question, sir. So is it a good question? Is it a good practice to apply for mean profit at that point in time only, or should you wait till the disposal of the suit?
No. Because you have to make a prayer right on the plane. The application baad mein hoega ho. If you don't have a prayer, the court will not grant you a mean profit. Please note that this is the stage you must make in the plane. If the court finds that the subletting defendant has sublet the premises without your permission and a profit hearing, you have to have mean profits. If you don't make it in the plane, that you don't get. And you have to ask for a prayer in the plane itself. Please note that. It is at the time when the court passes a decree, after giving the opportunity to the other side, court say that I pass the following decree. Defendant is the plaintiff is hereby directed to vacate the premises. And as regard mean profit, I hereby direct inquiry under order 20 rule 12 CCPC. Inquiry hoegi. There will be separate proceeding to be filed later on. That is called mean profit application. Wo alag se hota hai uske andar. There are different proceeding. You have to pay different court fees for that purpose, depending upon what the valuation. Oh, ye ho gaya rent act ka. Now, plaint must accompanied by an affidavit. Because section 26 tells you clearly of the CPC. Plaint should be accompanied by order 4, rule 1 CPC tells you the civil law is set into motion by presentation of a document called plaint. That is order 4, rule 1 CPC, read with section 26. 27, वही के समझ होता है. तो समझ उसके affidavit के अंदर लिखेंगे, I filed the above suit for eviction. I reiterate the cause of action. The statements are correct. I therefore pray that the decree be passed as per the. This is to make you accountable because plain verification clause आ गया. Okay? This is the small causes court. Now I will quickly jump to city civil court. So city civil court may, for example, the BMC want to demolish your premises. You have illegally constructed a loft, rightly or wrongly, you will take up the plea rightly. So when you are filing a suit against the BMC in Bombay, the suit against BMC will not lie in the small causes court. So you have to go to the city civil court or high court, depending upon the valuation. Now, assuming for the sake of argument, you are going to the high court, because up to valuation is 1 crore. So yahan pe against BMC 527 notice dena padega aapko. statutory notice to the commissioner. To the commissioner, please take notice that I am concerned for my client, Mr. So-and-so. Or the client can himself give. I am going to be the plaintiff in the present suit. I am filing against you. And because you are taking action against me, issuing a notice which is totally illegal, a sham, colorable bogus. I have not done anything and I am in legal possession. In the wake of the fact that you are denying and disputing my contention, I am moving the Honorable Court. I am therefore treat this notice as a statutory notice under Section 527 of the Municipal Corporation Act, and I will be filing and suing you and for appropriate order injunction, namely for a declaration that your notice is illegal, for a perpetual order of injunction that you should be restrained not to execute the decree and not to implement your notice, and for an injunction restraining you not to interfere, and for an injunction that you must withdraw the notice. Ye ho gaya aapka notice, wait for 2 months. If you are not able to wait for new notice, under Section 80 sub clause 2 ke andar court ko bol sakte yahan pe, I cannot wait for 2 months giving this notice. By the time I give notice, they'll demolish it. I may be permitted to file the suit that the notice giving it may be dispensed with. Issuance of notice may kindly be dispensed with for the time being and grant me injunction under Order 39, Rule 1 and 2 CPC. Court will grant you injunction, then give undertaking. After granting injunction, then I will give a statutory notice under 527 and wait for 2 months, then withdraw the present suit, then file a fresh suit. Okay, you must advise this. As a young lawyer, you should know this here. Please note that here. File a suit immediately, dispensing with the notice under 80 sub clause 2 of 2 and 4 of the CPC. Or dispense kara lijiye aap. Then file injunction ke liye apply ki. Normally the court grants it if you are able to prima facie show the cause. Primarily, it may not even grant if you don't have a case. Because the municipal deadline is that your premises must be in existence prior to particular period, 1st of April 1967, as a kuch period. That you should be able to see. Then your plaint will start in the Bombay City Civil Court, Bombay. Short cause suit number, long cause suit number. There are two types of suits here. Short cause means suit for injunction, simpliciter, short cause mein aata hai. And long cause suit is where contentious issues, where you file for declaration and for legal right, for nemurious right, because CPC tells you order 1, rule 2. The plaintiff must club all these prayers. You cannot segregate. Under order 2, rule 2, if you segregate, you don't take the leave of the court, your suit is barred. Ye sab cheezein janna padega aapko, please note that here. So in the Bombay City Civil Court, Bombay, short cause suit number so and so, plaintiff yourself, municipal corporation, is sufficient. Okay? Need not join ward officer, need not join anybody, unless you are attributing motives against them and claiming damages against them. Like somebody, I'm sorry that to say that somebody filed some lawyer filed a SLP through the police commissioner in Supreme Court against the minister in Maharashtra, the home minister, without joining him as a party. And the senior advocate makes a statement, sorry, Mr. Agisma, is a mistake. What kind of a mistake? You make allegation against the minister in Maharashtra and without joining him. In the administrative law, you are learned as a first year student. You cannot join, make allegation against anybody you have mollified without joining as a party. So please join that year. As senior lawyers are arguing in the Supreme Court and they don't advise this man, police commissioner, you are making allegation against the particular minister without joining him. The Supreme Court blasted them. You read the yesterday's news. So don't make this mistake. These are incompetent lawyers or lawyers who are overburdened and lawyers who do not want to work very hard. Please note that here. So it's a very shame that senior lawyers are also behaving this way and not giving correct opinion to the parties and making them spend crores or lakhs of rupees and time of the courts are wasted here. So don't do that here. So when you're joining, making allegation against a ward officer, you must join him as a party. Make allegation he has committed this wrong and he should be liable to pay me damages for this. So simpliciter, when there are no allegation, municipality is enough. So your prayers will, your starting plaint will be a plaintiff state as under your description. And defendants is a corporation amenable under action under the Municipal Corporation Act 1888. The subject matter of the present suit is a illegal, colorable, sham notice dated so and so issued under 351 of the Municipal Corporation Act, purported to demolish my premises, which is in existence. This said, in order to appreciate the facts of the case, the following facts are important. You mentioned I am in existence. The structure in existence for so many years, 40 years, 50 years, 10 years. It's a legal OC has been obtained. exhibit the OC. You have purchased the property in a legal manner from the builder. Exhibit your conveyance. And the property, it is shown, disclosed in your record, right of record. Mention it. Woh sab dikhane ke baad bataiye. This notice has been mischievously issued. It's a colorable exercise on the part of the corporation. It is sham, colorable, bogus. And you seek a declaration to the effect that the notice be set aside. Number one. Then perpetual order of injunction under section 39 of the Specific Relief Act. Relief Act for an injunction restraining him not to give effect to the notice. Then a mandatory injunction in case he has acted, some action to be taken. Then a prohibitory injunction order against him not to act upon it and give effect to it. Isn't it? Then add interim orders under order 39, rule 1 and 2 CBC. So your substantive prayers are under section 36, 37, 38 of the Specific Relief Act, where that is called substantive orders. Then you take out a notice of motion in the court for interim orders under order 39, rule 1, 2 and 3 CPC. So they have been pending the hearing and final disposal suit that this honorable court be pleased to grant so and so injunction. Oh, you have complained here. Then you give affidavit, notice of motion. Your plaint is ready. And move the court, take a circulation before the court that there's urgency in the matter. Your lawyer, you as a young lawyer, mentioned before the court, be giving a precipice. My lord, be pleased to permit me to mention this matter for tomorrow for urgent ad interim orders. I am likely to be dispossessed without due process of law by the corporation. The courts are very, very generous. They will grant you the prayer. Okay? This is the prayer and the city civil court. Now let us move the high court. You want to file a suit against a builder who is not giving you premises. He has cheated you. The flats in Bombay are costing crores of rupees. Kulabami, you have booked it, or maybe Randeri, or maybe in Churchgate area, maybe the flat, maybe 5 crore. So let us see. Anybody has any preference to give me? I can give you a suit out of my choice. Anybody has any choice? You want against a builder? You want against a government? You want government abitil ki hum logon ne? You want against anything else? Or arbitration? You want under section 9? Bataiye mere ko, because only one we can handle it. Shall I take a suit in the High Court Bombay against a builder? Shall I take a suit against in the High Court where a comprehensive suit is filed for administration where your grandfather left properties in Bombay, Calcutta, Madras? You take a leave under clause 12 of the latest patent. Okay? Malum hai na aap? Under the CPC, there's various remedies. Section 20 ke andar leave lena padega court ko. Suppose your grandfather died in Bombay, left properties in Calcutta, Madras, everywhere. You cannot file 10 suit under the scheme of order 2, order 1, under 2 CPC. One suit is enough. Uske liye leave lena padega. In the Bombay High Court rule, order clause 12 of the latest patent. We are governed by latest patent, which grants you the original jurisdiction to the High Court. Bombay, Calcutta, Madras High Court governed by the latest patent. Latest patent is a document which greets you. So you have to obtain the leave of the court, permission. Similar leave is mentioned in section 20 of the CPC and also leave under section 18 of the Presidency Small Cost Court Act, like clause 12. So leave like a file kar diya suit, place it here. So I am going on the footing. Let us go under the Specific Relief Act where the builder has not given you flat. You are challenging that agreement. The builder is getting a prospective purchaser who is giving him 10 crores. Your flat is sold for 9 crores. That's crore milta, so why should he give it to you? He will say that you have not paid me money in time. I am giving it to others. So you will be left with no other choice but to file a suit. So you are in the High Court of Judicature at Bombay, OOCJ. OOCJ, why? Because the Bombay High Court is a district court within the meaning of section 2 of the CPC. Please note that here. Bombay High Court, original side is a district court. Like under the provisions of the Indian Succession Act, only a district court can grant, only a district court can grant probate. That is a scheme of chapter 4 of the specific of the Succession Act, section 264, 265, dekhenge aap, the jurisdiction of the High Court granting here. Under the CPC, section 9 is the section granting power of the court to entertain the plaint. Section 9, important hai. So section 9 mein aapka plaint aa gaya. So isme kya rakhenge aap? You are a person who was desirous of booking a flat. Defendant is eminent builder. He built it here. So by virtue of agreement of sale dated so and so, you purchased the property for a consideration of 9 crore in the city of Mumbai, might be 5 square feet, sea facing flat. You paid full consideration. defendant was to hand over possession to, which he has not done it so far. I came to know that defendant has transferred the right title interest to third parties and sold it for a longer time. So here you file a suit for declaration that your agreement of sale is valid and subsisting under section 34 of the Specific Relief Act. You seek a declaration. My agreement of sale is valid and subsisting. And for a declaration that all agreements that the builder, defendant has executed with defendant number 2, 3 and 4 are illegal, sham, colorable, bogus, and subsequent document, they should be set aside. Okay? Decree for cancellation under section 34, 35 of the Specific Relief Act will clearly grant it. Then uske saath mein aap kya mangenge? That the defendant be directed to enforce the agreement of sale. He should be directed to execute the conveyance in your favor. He should be directed to put you in possession and legalize possession. So that is not only you have to ask for declaration, but a decree for possession, that the defendant be ordered and decreed to put you into possession. That the defendant be directed to pay you mean profits here for having put you out of the possession. Okay? ये सब चीजें जानना पड़ेगा. वो प्लेन तैयार हो जाएगा आपका. एंड नोटिस ऑफ मोशन इंटरिम ऑर्डर, नोटिस ऑफ मोशन में इंटरिम ऑर्डर ले लीजिए आप. सेम ऑर्डर 39 के अंदर सेम फॉर्मेट इज एप्लीकेबल हियर, लाइक सिटी सिविल कोर्ट एंड स्मॉल कॉजेस कोर्ट में सम स्मॉल वेरिएशन, नथिंग मच. ओके, ऑल प्लेन्स आर सिमिलर टाइम. या एनीबडी वांट टू आस्क एनी क्वेश्चन प्लीज आस्क मी.
इफ एनीवन हैज एनी क्वेश्चन दे कैन आस्क इट इन द चैट बॉक्स और दे कैन जस्ट अनम्यूट देमसेल्फ.
Ashish,
you are not audible. Can you please just write your question in the chat box?
Ha, bol dijiye please.
Can you hear me now, sir?
Yeah, I can hear you, but it's blurred.
Now, case handled properly on Tamil side.
Pardon?
The BM demolition case for Tamil
Nadu. Next time, lectures should please take on. They're not very clear, sir. I can't hear anything.
Ashish,
type your question.
आशीष का मशीन खराब है. आशीष, योर मशीन इज खराब, ठीक कराइए.
इन द मीनवाइल इफ एनीवन हैज एनी क्वेश्चन दे कैन आस्क अनम्यूट देमसेल्फ एंड आस्क द क्वेश्चन.
आज सम अदर सेशन रख लीजिए, क्या नाम है, प्लीज वन मोर आई कैन टेक लेना आफ्टर सम टाइम इन नेक्स्ट वीक. ओके,
ओके,
इफ स्टूडेंट्स वांट आई विल टेक इट बिकॉज़ टुडे नॉट ऑडिबल. And if you just, I think this is not very, I am giving lectures on Google. They are very clean. I don't know. I come today when Mansi was conducting on Zoom, they were very clear and audible. And today is a little giving some trouble. Five, 56 to? Kya bol rahe? What is the question? Anybody can?
So Ashish is asking, in Kangana Ranaut's case, was it held properly on Kangana's side?
See, I am not here to comment upon any personal case here because it is all politically, you know, contentious matters. And whatever the judgment has, High Court has given, we have to respect it. You know, of course, whatever the corporation has done in a case is not correct, according to me. And she should have been, they should follow the due process of law. And rightly, Justice Kathawala and the bench has passed the order, and I am totally support the view. But she should be given the opportunity of being heard. You just cannot go and demolish it. She may be wrong in hearing her views. For that, you cannot retaliate with the illegal action. She should be told to produce evidence. No, of course, under the provisions of the Maharashtra Regional Town Planning Act, there's a provision for regularization. You know that, no? There's a provision for regularization under Section 44. They can get up. You go before commissioner. You cannot just go and demolish it. Give an opportunity of being heard. Sanjana,
yes, sir. If anyone has any question,
I am in support of the order which has been passed in our favor. According to me, it's a correct order passed by the court, High Court.
Yes, sir. But was a lawyer correct in the process standpoint?
Let us not discuss the competency of lawyers because we all make mistakes. you know, all of us in a, you know, these all matters, serious matters filed in a spur of the moment, some mistakes do occur. Aage piche hota hai, let us see that. Let us not discuss about it. Okay. When you meet me personally, I will tell you. I do not want to hear my public criticism of somebody else. Not fair, you know. Samjhe na aap? Aur kuch hai? Anybody want to ask any more question, please?
Yes,
sir. What is the time, Mansi? Marcy, what is the time now?
It's 7:58.
I think there's no time now because you gave him 2 hours time. I think we are concluding. This 2 minutes, we can use it for question answer. And any further session you want and drafting and cases, I will take one more session. After next week, you can ask. Okay? In case you want. Yeah. Bata dijiye aap.
So one last question before we end up the session. Pratik Sharma is asking how much time it takes to upload FIR by police after filing an FIR.
FIR must be lodged, it must be registered forthwith. That is section U, section 154. Forthwith, immediately. They cannot waste a minute. Sandhana, immediately. And transmission to the magistrate also under section 155, 156, immediate.
Understood.
Immediate. And it's swing into action also immediate. And police is invoking power of arrest under 41 immediately, but not doing anything else. They are not recording FIR properly, and I don't think they are transmitting to me. In many cases, they are not transmitting to my magistrates. In my, I have seen the Bombay cases, it happened, unfortunately. Our push bolia?
Sir, how my will pleasure. The 24, excuse me, sir.
Pardon?
Sir, how will the 24 hours rule be applied when an accused is arrested on Saturday?
When a person is arrested, he has to be produced before the magistrate. There are a magistrate who works day and night, evening magistrate, the night magistrate.
Okay, so is magistrate court open on Sunday also?
Yes, there are holiday courts every day. Magistrate courts are like hospitals, 24 hours they are open. I have argued and appeared before many magistrate during my junior days, you know, plenty of them. And you make yourself available on Saturday, Sundays, if you have no other work to go. And many clients will come to you on the day and don't tell them. And there are, every bar association will be circulating messages, these are the holiday courts. If you come to know, these are the holiday magistrates, Saturday, Sunday, and their courts are working. In High Court and City Civil Court, Small Causes Court also, there are urgent matters, judges available to you Saturday, Sundays. In my junior days, I used to go literally almost every week before judges. Constantly, I used to appear for hoteliers, builders, everybody, and downtrodden section of the people. I was available. I used to sit in the High Court Law Library and invite people, everybody. I never had office those days. I used to sit and everybody used to come and as well. All seniors were watching me clearly. Yes, the gentleman is sitting, working hard. I used to come after my college lectures. I used to go 10 o'clock to the court, like court, and do matters. If there are no matters, go to reference section, keep on reading. Then evening may 7, library is open till 7:30. Thereafter, I used to go up third floor till 11:30. You know, junior days. They were enjoyable days, I would say that. I was learning and every client used to come. I used to take up all types of matters. And juniors working under me, they also used to be sent. All types. Income tax tribunal, sales tax tribunal, magistrate court, city civil, small causes court, cooperative court, high court, consumer court. I not left any forum, even in the High Court or Supreme Court also. I had 5-6 appearances so far because the clients are not able to pay. I normally tell the client, go and engage a lawyer in Supreme Court. It's expensive for you to take me and for your travel and stay and all. I normally recommend. But sometimes the people insist me, you come yourself. I go there. I have argued many matters, some successfully and some unsuccessfully. It's a beautiful experience. And I went to also several High Court, Jabalpur, Delhi High Court, Andhra Pradesh High Court, Mysore High Court. It's a great pleasure, you know. And you should appear, you get opportunity. According to me, all juniors, everybody get opportunity. Samjhana aap, ye kariye. Aur kuch puchna hai aapko?
So thank you so much for such an informative session. So but yes, unfortunately, due to time constraints, we won't be able to take any more questions.
Okay, no problem. Keep on the lecture. I'm available. Okay.
I would like to invite Prajwala Shishupal to give the vote of thanks.
My pleasure.
Prajwala?
Good evening, everyone. I, Prajwala Shishupal, would like to take the opportunity on behalf of Government Law College, National Service Scheme Unit, to thank Advocate Nusrat Shah for giving us his precious time and enlightening us with his knowledge. Thank you so much, sir. I would also like to thank Mansi Bhushan for her coordination throughout the session. I would like to thank our programming officer, Pratika ma'am, for always supporting and encouraging us. Our principal ma'am, Asmita Vaidya ma'am, for her constant support. And all the participants for joining us today. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much. And my respectful regards to our esteemed principal, whom I would like to have the opportunity of meeting. And all of you students also are very happy to meet. And my special thanks to Mansi, who has been kindly accepted my request to moderate the lecture along with Mr. Siddiqui, our student, and who has been very cooperative, in fact. And also my special thank to Ashish, who has also been assisting me in my other lectures on Ashish and Gitanshu. Both of them have been assisting very well under the able guidance of Mansi. And I should also would like to mention the name of our Dr. Ashish, who has also been very kind enough to help me in those lectures. I'm thankful to you. Thanks. Okay, my other lectures are taking place. Yes, thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, everybody. Have a nice day. Okay, good day.
Have a nice day. First lecture, stay tuned for more updates. Keep checking the college website for more.
Yeah. Okay, my pleasure. Bye-bye. May I take a leave? Good night. Bye.
Sure, sir. Bye, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mansi, ma'am.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.